Welcome, friend of child, and congratulations on the first day of your illustrious career with the Fatui. You sound remarkably sure of yourself. Remember, we are mere mortals. Our ideas are fluid like water. But back to the matter at hand. Child tells me that he has upheld his end of your agreement.
What agreement?
Correct. Child promised he would find someone to break the stalemate. And the Harbingers do not break their...
Ah!
Child is currently at Lioli Pavilion.
Oh, time ahem. There are two styles of cooking in Liyue, known as Li style and Yue style. They have been competing for centuries, but neither has emerged as the clear winner. The flagship restaurant of the Li style is the Lioli Pavilion. The owner especially chose to open the restaurant at Feiyuan Slope so they could compete face-to-face with the Xinyue Kiosk, which is the flagship restaurant of the Yue style.
Aha, you made it. As promised, I have found someone who can help you. Someone who can solve the mystery of why the Liyue Qixing would hide the Geo Archon's vessel.
So where is he? In Liyue?
He certainly is. I took the liberty of setting up a business dinner, as per the Liyue custom.
Welcome back, sir. You honor us with your patronage. Mr. Zhongli is awaiting your arrival in the room you booked.
Hi. Allow me to introduce Mr. Zhongli, consultant to an organization known as Wangsheng, and a trusted associate of the Fatui. Indeed, Wangsheng's line of work can be sensitive at times. Let's just say they understand when discretion is needed. And we, the Fatui, have always been glad to do business with friends who walk in the shadows.
Walk in the shadows?
It is an honor to meet you. I have heard tell of you from Mondstadt.
Discretion? Shadows? Is Wangsheng some kind of business involving dealing with people?
Indeed. It is as you have guessed. The Wangsheng Funeral Parlor organizes burials. We ensure that those who pass on do so in peace.
Did you think he was some sort of hired killer? The Fatui calls many such people friends, but the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor does not dabble in such business. Well, they are still... I shouldn't say too much. In any case, I brought you to meet Mr. Zhengli because...
Because I can bring you to see Rex Lapis's vessel.
What?
Don't be so surprised. Sure, the Geoarchon's body has been squirreled away by order of the Tian Chuan Ningguang. But first, let's hear what Mr. Zhengli has to say, shall we?
Rex Lapis may be the prime of Adepti, but he is ultimately an Adeptus. Many Adepti have left us over the millennia. This is the inexorable trend. The times have changed. You must have felt it too when you were at Jueun Karst. As you have seen, the time of the Adepti is ending, and the time of mankind is slowly dawning. In years past, Liu's tradition was that a huge memorial service be held to mark the passing of every Adeptus. But this time, the Qixing have made no attempt whatsoever to respect this tradition.
Yeah, the killer hasn't even been caught yet.
Deicide or not, the concern of the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor is this. When the ritual to receive this god is so kingly, it is all the more egregious for his final send-off to go unattended to. Traveler, Child has told me a lot about you. Since you have had dealings with the Animo Archon, could I ask you to help me prepare the Geo Archon's last rites?
A wise decision. The Tianchuan Ningguang has forbidden anyone from accessing Rex Lapis's vessel, which of course you would need to access if you were to achieve your goal of meeting all of the seven.
Precisely. Only by participating in the rite of parting will you be able to see the form of Rex Lapis again. If we are agreed, come with me. We will speak of the details as we walk.
All right, my bridge building work here is done. Turned out well, didn't it? You can go if you want to. Don't worry about me. I might just have a few more drinks and get acquainted with these things they call chopsticks in the meantime.
After having experienced the land of the absentee Archon, Traveler, how does it feel to know that our Archon and Adepti are here all around you in Liyue? Indeed, the weight of 3,700 years worth of history organizing the rite of parting should prove Liyue is the most prosperous of the seven nations, defended by deities and ruled by the Qixing. As Ningguang of the Qixing has always been on her guard against the Fatui. That is in all likelihood why...
What would Child get out of us doing the rite of parting anyway?
I neither know nor do I wish to know. As far as I am concerned, the Fatui are merely financial sponsors. These are the advance funds that Child has provided. If you use them up, you can go to him to apply for any subsequent funding.
Wow!
Well then, let us be off. The first step in our preparations shall be to a...
Uh,
Welcome to the Jade Mystery, my good friends. Would you like to try your luck betting on Jade? It's cheap and it's fun, and who knows, you just might...
Betting? No, we're here for... what was it again?
Noctilucas Jade, of Radiant Grade at the very least.
Radiant Grade, Noctilucas Jade? I see, you're not a tourist. My apologies. I have some here for your perusal. What do you think? The Jade Mystery is an old name in the jade business. Just look at that wonderful quality. Rex Lapis doesn't often bless us with such finery. Go on, pick whichever one you like.
These three pieces really do look pretty. Not like the ones you usually dig up. But how do we pick? Should we just grab one and go?
Oh? You want me to decide? That is fine as well. If it were me, the answer would be simple.
Oh? And that would be...
I'll take them all, boss.
Oh, you act with such panache, good sir.
Wait, boss! That one didn't count! Hey! If we only need one for the ritual, aren't we wasting three times the mora if we buy them all?
Oh, mora. It is as you say. I suppose I over...
Huh? How do you not think about mora?
If one must always consider mora before acting, then in all things one is bound by mora. All mora is currency, but not all currency is mora.
What? So loaded that he doesn't even bother...
No need to waver. Even when I am constrained by mora, evaluating the quality of Noctilucas Jade is indeed very tricky. As crude ore, there is little difference in texture, lustrousness, and internal pattern between good and bad jade. Only after the item made using Noctilucas Jade has taken shape will you be able to see whether it is up to par or not. If you return to those crafty merchants to quibble, they will counter by saying that your crafting bench is to blame, or that your heat control was poor.
Whoa! To think it's that easy!
But there is a way to truly evaluate this jade, and a true insider would know it. A fool sees the pointer and misses the moon.
What does that mean?
If you point at the moon with your finger, a wise man knows that you are pointing at the moon, the patterns, the facade. These are all the finger. Noctilucas Jade is a mystical stone used to light up the darkness. Noctilucas Jade of excellent quality would have superior pyro affinity. In other words, the bluer and brighter the luster of the ore under high temperature, I have imparted the priceless secrets of the jade trade to you.
Priceless, huh? Paimon's just said... We're back to buy some rocks, boss. But can you let us burn them first?
Burn them? You can't do that, my friends. If you were to do so, what would I have to sell? Fine. As you wish, then. How about this? I can take a small sample of all three. I'll take a bit of a loss. We'll count it as a friendly gesture.
Don't worry. I know the rules. As long as we can prove that it is good.
All right. Take these as samples. I've carved them off with a knife and tagged them to boot.
Aren't these too thin? Even paper's thicker. No, even a bug's wings are thicker. These are almost see-through.
Oh, you flatter me, but I have to be gentle. If I'd taken off even a bit...
But wouldn't something this thin...
It can't be helped. Trying to deprive a merchant of his profits would be like forcing a ravenous wolf to vomit up the food in its stomach. Nonetheless, under the right conditions, the...
What sort of conditions?
While we add the high temperatures using pyro, we can use hydro to reinforce it from within.
Oh! Oh, sir, to think you were...
Strictly speaking, asking for samples when we have not yet agreed to purchase the goods is a...
Well, guess we just need to find a place. You mean at Wan Min Restaurant?
That would not do. It is a place where people come and go.
Oh, Paimon remembers? We once saw this big... Now, let's...
Here's Becca.
A touch of frost. Submit for judging. My plan.
Don't get too close!
Starfall! Rumble apart!
answer from this world?
It has been a long time since I last set foot in the Nation of Wind. A friend of mine from Mondstadt would always bring a few bottles of locally brewed dandelion wine whenever he came to visit me in Liyue. It must be said that the famed liquor of the land of pastorals is far better than Sumeru's frigid snake wine.
Now that you're drinking.
Objects like this may prove useful when purging evil spirits.
That's the pot! It looks like the hilly trolls are still using it. It's a bit impolite, but we gotta cut the line. There's trolls sure have big appetites. This soup looks like it could be used as our hydro-elemental protection. We're ready to go. Paimon will help remember. Use pyro to keep making the pot hotter until we get the results we need. Mr. Zhongli said that the shinier and bluer the ore gets, the better it is. Noctilucus Jade! Hilly trolls are surrounding us again! Were they attracted by the light? Such nosy neighbors! Let's take care of them and continue again after.
Leave it all to me. Amber, reporting.
That light came from the second Noctilucus Jade, didn't it? More hilly trolls. They don't give up, do they? Looks like they're mad that we ruined their food.
I must leave no stone unturned.
Pew-pew! Look at you, food now.
Starfall!
No escape!
Drop!
Jade, wasn't it? It was so much shinier than the rest. Let's go with that one. Let's head back to the gym. Mystery time.
You're back, my friends. I've kept the goods for you. Which of them would you like?
Exactly! That's the one Paimon remembers, too!
No problem. If you have your eye on this one, you can have it.
Then we'll take a box of the third type of jade.
Done. All the same, and pardon me for asking, but I...
I suppose it would not hurt to tell you.
Parting? Oh, dear. It's hard to believe. Even though the Jade Mystery has been in decline, it is said that when our Lord lost his way while going incognito in the city 200 years ago, it was a spoon from the Jade Mystery. Alas. Alas, all things must pass. Well, if this is to be used to say farewell to Rex Lapis, then I shall sell this to you at half the price.
Are you sure? You didn't want to even give us an inch before.
If not for our Lord's protection, this city wouldn't exist as it does now. No proprietor could earn money off such a thing.
Oh, I'm sure Rex Lapis will feel your sentiment, boss.
In the safe hands of the Liu Achising and good, honest merchants such as yourself.
All right. Thank you, my friends.
Now that we've made our choice...
Hey, wait a minute! He said it was happening.
Oh, right. I'm sorry. As I thought...
Any what?
Mora. My apologies. Another oversight on my part.
Oh, that won't do. This isn't some small sum. Oh, that's a relief. Have a look, boss. Is it enough?
It's fine. Just enough for half price. Though, to be honest, it'd be all right.
Well, it's settled then. Let's take this
Look at you, bossing everyone around. You didn't cough up a single mora.
It seems that we... We can leave the jade here. I have already called for a jewelsmith to shape them into... Ah, yes. I have yet to go and see Child. So, as for the jewelsmith's remuneration...
Guess we can't do anything else. Also, is this where we're doing the
Yes. I have already rented this location, and have begun making preparations for the rite. That's right. The Liyue Qixing have acquiesced to using...
But when something this big happened here, should suspects like us really be at the crime scene? Although with that said, since we got back from Dwayne Karst, none of those pesky also, the...
Traditionally, we call it the...
Ah, right! That's what it was called. You seem to know everything, Mr. Zhongli. So, was this Exuvia hidden away by the Qixing? I mean...
One must think that they already have someone in mind. Or perhaps they already know. Surely they must have found all the evidence that there is to find. These things are for the authorities in Yujing Terrace to consider. Before the rite is conducted, the Exuvia will be kept...
Golden House?
The only mint in Liyue. Which is to say, the only mint in Teyvat. All the more that...
Oh, no! Paimon wasn't thinking about anything bad. But why do you know this, Mr. Zhou?
Since the rite of parting has the approval of the Qixing, it is a semi-official event. As such, there is already some limited information available. Perhaps each has their motives. But this is the cap in Liyue, where the god of contracts reigns. Only contracts may not be betrayed. I, for one, have no issue with little men. Well then, we should go and prepare the-
Perfumes?
No. Perfumes used to honor the gods must be fresh. Silk flower petals contain a fibrous material of good quality, often used in-
It's time for Zhang Li's lectures.
We shall not speak of the detail.
Can't beat the atmosphere here and be there.
Hey, boss, do you sell silk flowers?
Silk flowers? We sir.
Which kind? The good kind? The best kind? Remind Paimon what kinds there are again.
Ugh, you ignorant shoppers. Always coming in here.
Golden House Maiden, Valley Weaver, and Fate's Yearning. One of each to start with, if you don't mind.
My goodness. Yes, this you two must be his servants. Please refrain from any further attempts to contribute. I'm sorry. Ah, yes. We've met before, haven't we? Now then, please peruse at your leisure.
Silk flowers exhibit different properties based on how their environmental conditions differ from their ancestral habitat. Just look at the abundant foliage here. And these stamens, glamorous by contrast. This variety thrives in any dark, damp location, often in large clusters. Lastly, this strain is quite the recluse. Unlike its exuberant cousins, flowers and foliage are minimal. Silk flowers have all but disappeared from the wild today due to geographical changes over.
Wow! A true connoisseur!
I possess but a smattering of trivial knowledge. My traveler friend is the one to watch. They are on track to set foot in every corner of the world.
Oh, Mr. Zhongli, you're way too humble. So which...
I'll take them all, boss.
Again?
How can I put this? When purchasing opera tickets, it is natural to decide based on which singer, but this silk flower purchase is not. Perhaps you don't know. Tradition states that we should decoct perfume from different subspecies. Like several other tedious and complicated traditions, this one has become simplified over time. But this is the only rite of parting to take place for one of the seven in 3,700 years. As such, I do think we should honor tradition down to the last detail in this case. Now that's settled, a question. Do you have any mora on you?
You forgot to bring money again? Zhongli.
If I may interject, did I hear you say?
Yes, in
a- Gosh, well, why didn't you say so? It would be bad luck to say it out loud. But since these flowers will be you-
Are you serious?
Why wouldn't I be? If he hadn't written those poems in praise of my wares, they'd only be worth a fraction.
Huh. So much folklore here revolves around Liyue's-
Thank you, boss.
Our skins? You were the one who forgot to-
Please,
So, now that we've got the flowers-
Ideally, with the help of an expert. Unfortunately-
Talk about first world-
Hence, I need you to help by asking around in the city.
So this time, we get to go around town looking for nice-smelling ladies?
I will wait for you near the Statue of the Seven.
Maybe we can find some good candidates at the Adventurers Guild. Let's ask Lan! She's master of the Liyue branch, right?
Ad Astra Abyss.
I stopped accepting commissions a long time ago. Sorry, you two, but you'll just have to ask another adventurer.
Oh, it's not that kind of favor. It's just a teeny tiny thing.
Do I look like the kind of girl who wears perfume to you? I think you're
Well, Paimon thinks you smell amazing. So come on, Lon. What's your
Now that you mention it. Yes, there is something. Oh, it must be from the Qingxin flowers I picked on the way back.
Aha! The truth is out. Lon's got a soft spot for
No, they were Anyway, this is a pointless conversation. If you want to know about perfume
The fortune teller, right? Paimon, remember, she smells pretty good. Thanks, Lon. See you around.
Should I save this money?
Long sword in hand, and the world at my feet.
Hello. How may I help?
We've come to ask you a question.
Perfume? I rarely think to use it. That said, some of the cosmetics I use are scented. Since I usually set up my stall by the docks, I avoid perfume like the plague, because Celestia forbid those lusts.
That's the worst thing.
While we're on the subject, have you never heard anyone-
Yang-Air?
Yes, that's her. Many-
Great! This is just-
Well, hello. You found me at last.
What? How did you know we were
Oh, I heard a rumor about a couple who were snooping around. Actually, I was starting to worry you wouldn't find me. This is the ultimate test of my appeal, after all.
Snooping around? Why are you making
What can I say? People love to talk. Maybe you ought to be more discreet in the Relax. I know why you're here. You want to get your hand on my homemade perfume, don't you? What kind would you like? 3-in-1 go. My goodness. You have extreme tastes for someone your age. Maybe the rumors I heard were true after all. You're on the prowl and... Is that the best you could come up with? Even if you were genuinely offering perfume to a deity, that doesn't explain why you...
Zhang Li was right. People don't remember this...
As one of my favorite poems goes. Oh, cherry tree,
That went over Paimon's head.
In short, I'm happy to help. Traveler, you can be my assistant. So, where is a good place for making sweet, sweet perfume? You mean Wanmin Restaurant? I've had a word with Chef Mao. We can start work now. Are you ready to please me?
What did you...
I meant make me proud. As my well, I'm setting up. You...
Try something new at the Wangmin restaurant. Try something new at the Wanmin restaurant.
Have you fetched the water? Have a look behind Wanmin restaurant. Chef. This water will do nicely. Now, I need you to extract the silk flower essence using a crafting bench. Perfume making uses an altogether different technique from alchemy. Here, let me teach you. Very carefully, take hold of the mortar and pestle. Gently does it. You need to keep your wrist firm so your hand doesn't slip. Now, use your strong hand to stir it with a persistent rhythm. Ooh, you're a Now, take these and try it out on your own. You don't forget to do all three. They look visually identical during the essence extraction process, but I... Wow, this is some exquisite silk. The essence is placed into water and simmered. You must take care to control the heat during this process. So please, focus on controlling the heat. Don't waste a drop of the... All three perfumes are ready. And you, my friend, were a testament to the lengths you will go to for romance. It's so rare to see nowadays. Anyway... Shall I give you a brief overview of each scent? This first one is sweet as candy, straight out of a fairy tale. Younger women will love it. The second one is for those with more refined tastes, the first choice for daughters of high society. Finally, the third one has a soft but lingering scent, like a mist that captures the last light of dusk. All clear? Don't get them mixed up now. Good. Be sure to I'll leave you with some parting. One who tries to sail three boats simultaneously should be careful. Come and...
Let's take these three perfumes over to the Statue of the Seven. Mr. Zhongli's probably been waiting... Did we take too long? You were just staring up at...
You're back. Compared to the watch that Rex Lapis's statues have kept over Liyue.
Well, how can a person compete with...
That is true.
Three sets?
Thank you both. Let us offer them up.
This is the first kind of perfume. Miss Yinger said that it's sweet as a dream. This is the second kind. It's got an... The third kind has a gentle but lingering fragrance. Something, something like the dusk mist. And it's a big... Oh, what was that? That's the one older ladies like. Does that mean that Rex Lapis...
Rex Lapis has taken on countless forms.
What a shame. We only got to see the... Let's hope that...
We can leave that to the authorities. Let us focus on the fond farewell for Rex Lapis.
So, we finished another step in our preparations. What's next?
Next, I would like the two of you to help me borrow the cleansing bell.
Cleansing bell?
At present, a friend of mine named Madame Ping is the guardian of the cleansing bell. She lives near Yujing Terrace. If you ask her, she will know what to do.
Sure, but aren't you going to come with us?
Ah, I have certain reasons why I cannot be there in person.
Man, what?
All things must change. It's nothing. I just...
What happened to them?
Back in my day, people said the glazed lilies, if they heard beautiful sounds like laughter and sing, but... If they heard too much wild gossip.
So that means these flowers feel what's happening in Liyue?
Yes. The rumors of Rex Lapis's death are... Some say it was a Fatui plot. Others say that the Qixing made it all up. This harbor is like a mountain of dry tinder. Well, I shall say no more. This old woman's grown too old and naggy. Did you borrow something? Apart from that, I don't have anything, but it was not originally mine either. I was a vain beauty when I was young, and I would pester him for that bell, or he could not dissuade me, and so he gave it to me. But he said that if someone should come to... It has been many years, and still, though, I... Oh, these old bones are so slow to look for things. I doubt you can wait that long.
That's right, Granny. We'll follow you back home and...
All right, children. There is no need to worry.
Do you live near here, Granny?
Oh, an old lady like me can't afford to buy a place in this city. See this ceramic teapot? My entire household is in here.
How does that work?
Oh, youngsters. I simply mean that the bell is somewhere inside this teapot, and you are quite welcome to borrow it. If you can find it. Youngsters, this is where this old woman keeps all her things. Quickly now, go fetch that bell.
Whoa! That sounds like Granny's voice! So, this is our teapot? What's going on?
Oh dear, so many cobwebs. It seems I really haven't cleaned it in a long while. Sorry to trouble you, children. Please help an old lady clean up.
A touch of frost! Spirit blade! For judgment.
Granny could also be an adeptus? Paimon's more and more convinced that she's an adeptus. But don't they all live in Trillium?
touch of frost. One with my blade, from whence you came!
I'd win.
How many levels does this teapot have? It would be nice if we had one of these too. Or at least we wouldn't have to camp outside.
You found it. Youngsters are so quick on their feet. Oh, now, let me see. All right, that'll do. In and out in no time. You youngsters really are quick. An adeptus. Oh. As to whether I am one or not, child.
Paimon kinda knows what you mean. But is also, don't you think it's weird? Something's just happened to Rex Lapis.
Oh, don't be silly. Leo a harbor, but no matter what, we have always preferred to cry, catch the murderer at the top of one's lungs, but now that you have come to borrow the bell, I guess that perhaps an old friend of mine is so. Why would I be unwilling to lend you the bell?
Hey! It belongs to Granny! We're supposed to return
one. Oh, let you keep it. But this bell gets homesick sometimes. Well, you must have things to do, since you have. Oh, and do tell the puppet. If they have time, they can come over for tea. I don't have...
We will!
Indeed. This is the cleansing bell. Let's place the perfume we've prepared inside. Of course. How would I know that the bell...
That's suspicious. But if you don't want to... Oh, yes! That old grand... If you have the time, you can come over for tea. I don't have much to offer.
That tone does not suit you. Still, her teapot is indeed very good. There are none when a suitable time arrives. I'll bring a spot of...
So what's the next step in our preparation?
Next, we...
Ooh, Paimon loves kites! Are you taking us kite flying?
No. Kites are children's toys, yes. But they all... I will explain it to you. But our next course of action should probably be to purchase the kites.
Oh, sure.
You're here. The seven...
Yes, thank you.
It's rare to see customers who want to buy this type of kite nowadays.
Well, this is Mr. Zhang Li from the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. We've talked about a whole bunch of things while traveling with him. He seems to know Liyue's favorite topics, money and government, really well. But it...
Well, that's because I prefer to share fun things with you.
Children's toys are very fun things, that's for sure. Finely crafted toys are well loved by children, but this craft itself has been honed over thousands of years, and there is meaning behind that. I have made kites in Liyue for 40 years, and I am intimately familiar with the forms passed down from...
Indeed. These are decorations used in the rite of parting. The seven kites represent...
I took the liberty of coloring outside the lines when doing the... As for the kite that honors the Geo Archon, one must follow the contract.
Ah, Paimon's heard that name before.
The design of this kite displays a firm grasp on the cyclicality and eternity. These markings of tree and leaf. Justice flows across the surface of the waters. War rages like a flame. As does that which the Cryo Archon once... Yes. These details are masterfully done.
Compliments of a learned man truly are pleasant.
Well then, Granny Shan, I shall take these back with me. As for the payment...
Well, allow me.
Hey, it's Child!
No, I see Mr. Zhang Li's the same as ever. When paying, well, when getting others to pay for him, he neither looks at the price tag nor his wallet. He knows a great deal about money, and about the trials of the common man. He just doesn't consider poverty to be something that could ever happen to him. Or perhaps, you could say that he cannot imagine himself like...
How has he not died of hunger yet?
Child, you are as fond of jokes as ever. Well then, since we've purchased our kites without incident, there's no need to take a break before moving to the... The rite of parting requires helping hands as well as materials. We should be able to find some people near the harbor.
Oh, by the way, take this bag of money. You probably won't want to let Zhang Li do the bargaining, if you know what I mean. Seems I missed out on some interesting information. I suppose I'll just have to find a more opportune moment next time.
Listen, let me tell you. hiring help? Sure. But let me just say first that I'm a reserve member of the Adventurers Guild.
Adventure? Venturing into the mountains to capture a few crystal flies?
Eh? That's not hard. Almost a bit too easy for a reserve adventurer.
A most fair price.
Five geocrystal flies. Yes, I do think...
A full day of odd jobs at Yujing Terrace.
Whoa, that's expensive.
Hero of Mondstadt?
Well, you may never have heard of this hero, but it seems you've heard of Mora nonetheless. Thus, I will simply...
This is too little. I'd consider it if it was a... This price'll do. No loss to me for a...
Always put in 100% effort into everything I do. Of course, there'll be a premium if you want me to give a hunt, so what's the job?
Let me see. We are...
No problem.
Done.
All finished then? Splendid. Any leftover cash is yours to keep. A favor for the Fatui should never go unrewarded.
You think you can buy us off with some loose change? No way! Paimon demands to know when the next payment is coming!
Well, how does this sound? You give me the information I need.
What info do you need? Huh. Does that mean you know what he's after? Yikes! You're right! Signora!
You both need to calm down. Just what is this about? The atmosphere got...
Next, we need some everlasting incense. For this, we need to go to Boo Boo Pharmacy, the finest pharmacy in all of... Is...
Everything is fine. I was just informing them that they... Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm...
Paimon definitely felt like Child wasn't happy with us just now.
Thank you.
receptionist. Hello.
Welcome to Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Huh? Did you?
The reception, it seems.
How about? Oh, there you are. But you can't even reach the counter. Joke's on you. Paimon floats. So hug anyway. There's something weird about it. Can't be.
Welcome to Boo Boo Pharmacy. Once upon a time, Chi-Chi died. Then, Chi-Chi was saved by the Adepti. Now,
something like this would be...
Hello?
Excuse me, sir.
Surely no prescription is needed to purchase...
Chi-Chi can get your medicine, but only if you show Chi-Chi your prescription. These are Chi-Chi's orders from...
Zombies are limited to acting within the confines of their orders. And somehow in this case, the zombie... My dear Chi-Chi, we didn't bring a prescription, I'm afraid. But we do hope...
Okay, then.
How did you manage that?
But... Chi-Chi helps.
Since when do customers need to...
Never mind. Just think of it as a peer-to-peer transaction.
Go to Mount Tianheng, find the Guizhong Ballista, and hunt a cocoa goat. Please and thank you.
It's a kind of crossbow located in Tianheng Pass. It was designed to automatically...
Mr. Zhang Li really knows Leela inside out.
Apparently not quite. This is the first I have ever heard of the cocoa goat.
The cocoa goat is a legendary animal, an adepta beast.
Did you want to add anything else, or...?
No, just that the cocoa goat is a legendary. What it looks like, don't know. Where to find it, don't know either.
Very well then. Let's start by investigating near the Gui...
It's huge! Paimon can tote, but how do you operate this? What?
After millennia of wear and tear, even a...
So what are we gonna do?
You almost make it sound like I'm some sort of bourgeois parasite. That said, let me... As I recall, there is a military... If we can retrieve the spare parts from...
So...
I have a with the parts in hand, I could at least... These parts look useful. One moment. I will try to repair the device. It is done. The Guizhong Ballista is more intricately designed than I thought.
Ooh! Now how do we turn it on?
It's easy enough. We simply need to do this. Look, it even has a scope.
Over here we have... nothing. And over there... more nothing.
Hey! Just what do you think you... So you fixed up this turret because you're planning to do what?
Not a turret. A Guizhong ballista. Also, kindly state your name.
Are you blind or something? This area is supposed to be chock full of hidden treasures, but you can't get anywhere near them with this thing keeping watch. In my last time we approached the mountain, and nearly a few of us risked our lives to disarm it, which amazingly we managed. And then we turn our... The next thing you'll be repairing...
Tut, tut. Vandalizing the legacy of an... It is not we who need rep...
My play. Submit for judgment.
Starfall! Crumble apart! Let it rain! Get
him! Swift and merciful!
I'm a rock! Look at you, food!
A touch of frost. Submit for judgment.
Pew pew. Can't handle your dream. No escape.
Starfall.
These lowlifes didn't know.
Troubling ourselves over this rabble is not worth it. A search using the Guizhong ballista revealed no significant life forms nearby. What's more, a contraption built using Adeptus technology should have no trouble detecting an...
Which means... A Paimon wouldn't go that...
We won't solve anything while standing here and racking our brains. Let's return...
Good idea. We did...
Forgive us. We were unable to fulfill our end of the contract.
What a disappointment.
Aw, poor Chi-Chi. Why does Paimon feel so guilty?
Cocoa goat milk is tasty. So tasty. I'm sorry. I have a poor memory. Ah, here. This is the name.
Huh?
I owe you both an apology. I hastily agreed to what appeared.
Never mind, Zhongli. You didn't know. As the Leeward proverb goes, all.
Excuse me, everyone.
Oh. Sorry, but Paimon's gonna leave the job of shattering this poor kiddo's world to you.
No.
It seems Chi-Chi took this pretty hard.
Someone learnt a valuable life lesson today, then. Thank you all for looking after my little Chi-Chi.
Might I ask who?
Ah, how rude of me. I'm Baiju, boss of the Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Paimon thought Chi-Chi was the boss. Turns out it's some wacko who wears medicinal and...
What a sorry state of affairs. This little mascot is even more of a simpleton than Chi-Chi.
I prefer to stay silent, but faced with strangers, I must speak, lest you mistake me for an escapee from the medicine cabinet.
Don't mind Chengsheng. She's a good girl, really. As for you three, communal chaos causing with Chi-Chi aside, what business brings you here?
Do you sell everlasting incense in this fine establishment?
Everlasting incense? Why, of course we do.
Together.
3 million mora. Top quality. Guaranteed.
You might as well just rob the Golden House. Oh, but the chasing of take.
3 million. An innocuous number.
It's a crazy number. We'd never be able to make that much mora. And as for Mr. Zhongli.
This is correct.
What are we gonna do? Is this the.
Cocoa goat. My sides hurt. Oh my goodness. I cannot believe you fell for that.
Hey, let's laugh.
I'm almost in tears over here. Thank you. That was the best laugh I've had in a long time. In return, I'm more than happy to sort out this mess you've managed to get yourselves into. Excuse me, sir. Dr. Baiju, isn't it? Truly honored. I'm Child, one of the Fatui Harbingers. If Boo Boo Pharmacy needed a stable supply of, say, coconut milk, the Fatui could help by setting up a robust and speedy district.
Strange. I knew the Fatui infiltrated businesses with seductive deals, but-
Coconut milk. Baiju, quick. Chi-Chi wants coconut milk.
Ah, yes, of course, Chi-Chi. Anything you want. Thank you, Child. I look forward to a successful collaboration in the future.
That's like zero different.
2,990,000. Well, now that this is settled, we must head back to Yujing Terrace. Mr. Child, Dr. Baiju, little Miss Chi-Chi, see you soon.
Ah, that lot is an absolute riot. Honestly, I can't remember the last time I laughed so hard. So, you've been eavesdropping, I hope?
Yes, Master Child. They spoke of the Qixing taking the-
Well. Ningguang and her Qixing cronies. What else would they be hiding in the gold? I apologize, but I warned you, didn't I? As the old Leo is-
As it stands, we've hired helpers, and we've acquired the Everlasting Inn. Well, Traveler, have you gained anything from our odd? Which is it, I wonder? The questions that such travels raise are ever so complicated. Well, I'll leave you to treat you to a meal. Oh, yes, don't worry. Tonight, I shall take you both to an old hole in the wall. Praise.
Hole in the wall? As in a cool...
Indeed. Let us meet near the harbor. Ah, you're here. There's no need to order. I've a third round knockout is not for lightweights, like those taverns in Mondstadt. Here, the owner does not take such unorthodox orders as fruit juice. I ordered some wine-fermented sweet rice balls for you, if that counts.
If it is to your liking, dear customers, I...
Hey, there's even a storyteller!
Besides fine wine... The excellent ambiance is the reason why this place is so well loved. But when I say ambiance, I refer to a different sort from the one the Teyvat Travel Guide uses to judge other establishments.
As you all know, high above the land of Liyue lies a pavilion in the clouds, a palace in the mist. What does it mean to have all-seeing eyes? This, my friends, Lady Ningguang, imagine. The weather is... Behold, the glorious sight. They say that when Lady Ningguang ponders important affairs, she retreats to her jade chamber with none but her three closest confidants in tow. Why brings she these trusted three to sift through sources, dig through documents, looking for information? Piece by piece, facts and figures paint a picture on the walls of the chamber. But well before the wall is filled, Lady Ningguang's mind is made up. Having made her call, she has every last document shredded, and whoosh! She scatters the shavings out her window. Ah, look at them, how they billow in the wind like a sudden swirling blizzard. As the fragments fall, traces of text flicker before the eyes of the merchants of Liyue, like ink stains in white snow. The saying goes, the rarest treasures in the land are the words brought by the paper snow. For the words of the Tianquan have the power to move mountains, and all throughout the land know it. These are but scraps of paper, and yet they guide Lady Ningguang's hand. Such is their value. Merely grasping one or two of them will surely gift you a fragment of her wisdom, enough to stay a step or two ahead of your peers.
Tianquan Ningguang. Feels like we're hearing this name a lot. Liyue locals talk about her, huh?
At last I have found.
Who's there?
Wait, I am not with the Millilith. Nor am I here to However, I am an emissary of the Liyue Qixing. My name is Ganyu, secretary at the Yuahai Pavilion, and I have come specifically to meet you. Well, in concrete terms, I am the
Ningguang sent you?
My apologies, you who have returned from Jiayun Karst. I am duty-bound and cannot, but I have with me a letter from Lady Ningguang. She invites you to her palace.
An official invitation?
Lady Ningguang said this. Invite her to come. I wish to meet at the Jade Chamber. Together we shall
And with that, the emissary who called herself Ganyu just disappeared. But we've received an invitation from the Liyue Qixing. Paimon still can't believe it. We'll be meeting people that have way more money than Paimon could ever count. We should be on our best manners.
An invite. You'd best.
Don't worry.